2NURFM, a broadcast service of the University of Newcastle.
It's 2NURFM 103.7, and it is that time of the week where we get to catch up with our exercise physiologist. G'day, Mark. How are you doing?
I'm fabulous as usual. How are you?
Look, I'm not doing too bad, but your little fella, he's still asleep. You said he's got the flu and he's just sleeping.
Yeah, well, he's got some sort of virus. And, he got to bed about 11 o'clock last night because he wasn't feeling great. And so now he's up to about 11 and a half hours of sleep and he's sleeping it off. And so that's why we thought we'd talk about sleep and the importance of it.
Look, I think most of us are getting this awful flu and cold that's going around at the moment. And you can absolutely relate when you're not well. All you want to do is sleep, and that's just a sign of the body going, hang on, I need to repair here.
Yeah, and that's what sleep basically is. It's our repair process. So these days when people are getting a lot less sleep and they're getting broken sleep, it sort of feeds into a lot of the problems that we're having in terms of inflammatory responses with injuries and things like that. So, look, sleep is incredibly important and we probably don't get enough.
It's one of those things that I think we've heard our whole lives that sometimes it's easy to go, meh. We've all heard that you need sleep. And it wasn't until yesterday where I was reading some stats and having a chat about how important sleep is that it made me go, wow, like I'm actually reducing my life expectancy by not getting enough sleep.
Yeah, very much so. And if you have a look at the research on what people go through with sleep apnea, so people that snore a lot or can't sleep and they get broken sleep, it really affects. They can get increases in blood pressure. They're constantly sick. They have difficulties losing weight. It affects their memory. It's huge in terms of what it does to our body.
And your fine motor skills, gross motor skills.
Yeah, like everything. And, your stress levels go through the roof. It's pretty chronic. And, a lot of people these days don't sleep enough because we're on these stupid phones and watching our iPods and our iPads before we go to sleep. And, it really impacts on what we're doing.
So what's the magic number? Because I'm guessing 6 hours a night, which I get, and a lot of people I know sort of get around 6 hours. That's not enough.
No, look, 8 hours is the magic number. I get about 7. That said, last night I slept for about 9.5 hours, so probably the body needed to catch up in some way, shape or form. So, look, 8's the magic number, but we live a really ridiculously busy life, so it's about sleep quality. They say that if you can get 2 really deep quality hours of sleep, it's just as effective. And some people, function really well on 6. You clearly function well on 6.
that's the coffee.
7's my magic number, but it's about individualised needs. But the thing is, it's about what we do before we go to sleep. We can't be on our phones. We can't be on our computers. We've got to take a moment to just chill. Talk to your partner. Talk to your friends or whoever you're living with and engage in something that's not just sitting on the phone and getting that blue light, which actually keeps us up.
Because you need to let the brain just sort of
unwind.
Unwind. Is the television okay for that?
We should turn it all off and just have half an hour of downtime just to allow our body to actually recover and
what a bizarre
unwind.
Concept, talking what, to
yeah,
the people
and imagine
we live
talking
with.
To the people you live with. It's really weird. It's random. Like, why would we do that? That's we only did it 15 years ago and it seemed to work for us. So.
But you're absolutely right. And there are times where you do that, where you go, right, for whatever reason, you're sitting out on the deck and you might, be having a chat or having a wine, and you seem to sleep so, not because of the wine, you seem to sleep so much better when you're not there constantly being stimulated by pictures and lights flashing and whatever else.
Yeah,
and
we
do.
Look, it affects, if we don't sleep, it affects everything. We don't have energy in the day. So it's like we're talking about motivation and exercise. Well, if you're not getting enough sleep, you're not going to be motivated to do anything. You're not going to have the energy to exercise. You're going to increase your risk of injury. So, it's so important that we actually work out, what works for us, get a regular routine going, so it's making sure that you're going to bed at a regular time. Some people, my staff, the girls that work for me, are in bed by 9:30. I don't know how that happens. Admittedly, they don't have kids. For me and my wife, midnight's a normal night. So,
wow, okay.
Yeah, but it's about what's normal for you. Some people are morning people, some people are night people, but it's about getting your routine and sticking to it. And as long as it's consistent and you're doing those things like having some downtime before you go to sleep, you'll sort of notice how much energy you've got during the day, and you're not having to pump 5 or 6 coffees into you to get you going.
Which would be really nice. So, Mark, I guess the message is for anyone at home, for anyone at all, but I guess particularly if you've got an injury or you're looking at possibly getting some work for that, first thing you can do, you can start tonight, put down any technology.
Yep.
have a chat to your partner, you know, find out how the day is, and then try to get those 8 hours of rest and get into a routine.
Absolutely. Try and get the 8 hours. You know, talk to your partner instead of messaging them or having a, or talking to them on Facebook. They're right next to you. Maybe have a chat to them. It's a wonderful concept.
I'll get give it a whirl. Let you know how I go.
Let me know how you go. Get those 8 hours of sleep and you'll be amazed. You're not going to need all the coffee you need to get through the day. If you're having 5 or 6 coffees to get through the day, you're clearly not getting enough sleep.
Absolutely. I just wonder how many people are going to be ringing you saying, I didn't plan on another baby, Mark, but I listened to your advice. It's 26 past 10 onto a new RFM. Mark Goswell will be back same time next week.